Hi, my name is Rena Deutsch and I'm a Jewish educator and motivational speaker in Toronto, Canada. What would you do if you were given one of the most powerful tools in the world? You would probably try your best to figure out how to use it in the way that it was intended for the maximum benefit. What would you do if you were given one of the most destructive weapons in the world? You would probably be extra cautious with it and keep it under lock and key to try to protect people from it. The truth is, you and I have been given access to both these things. The gift of speech has the potential to be one of the most powerful tools that we have at our disposal to build relationships with ourselves, with Hashem, and with people around us. But it also has the potential to be destructive. And when it comes to social media, the words we use can either be a powerful tool of mass construction or a painful tool of mass destruction. Our words carry weight. They affect the reality around us, and not just in theory. In Jewish law, the mere act of saying words can literally change the status of things. Making the bracha on the candles changes Friday into Shabbos. Long ago, saying that something was going to be donated to the Beis HaMikdash made it hekdesh and was never allowed to be used for anything else. When a man puts a ring on a woman's finger and says the words, Hare at mikudeshes li betabas zu, that you are now consecrated to me with this ring, he changes the status of the two of them from single people to a married couple. The effect that our words have are only amplified through the lens of social media. By getting out to so many people across such vast distances, we have the ability to affect the realities of so many with just one click. Knowing this, we need to do our utmost to try to harness that power for the positive. Whether it's sharing words of Torah, bringing a smile to someone's face, sharing a little positivity and encouragement, there is so much potential benefit from the proper use of social media. At very least, we need to make sure to do no harm. We're taught that we were given both teeth and lips as a double guard against speaking hurtful words. But when it comes to social media, we have a third defense right at our fingertips. Before we share something, we should think to ourselves, what is the benefit of this? How does putting this out into the world help create a more positive reality? Before we reply to something, we should consider, does this really need to be said? Is there a nicer way for me to say it? Does it need to be said in public? Could it be a private conversation? It can be harder to control or edit what comes out of our mouths. But the reality that we shape through our interactions on social media is literally in the palms of our hands. Let's use the power we have to try to shape a reality that is more positive, more loving, more empathetic, more understanding, more tolerant, and a place where our relationships can really be built and thrive. So next time you're scrolling or messaging and thinking about putting something out into the world, remember that what you use your thumbs to say is just as important as what you use your mouth to say. Be careful and kind with your words and help shape a reality that we can all be happy to be a part of.